looking at the question on the screen, we are told that the radius for the crank AB and DC is what? Is 45 mm, all right? And also the distance between crank A and crank C is what? Is 120 mm. So from the center of this perpendicular to the center of this perpendicular is what? Is 120 mm, all right? And with radius 45, I am drawing my A, my crank AB with radius 45, I draw, okay? And with the same radius 45, I draw my crank CD, my crank CD. Okay, so the next thing is to divide each of the crank into what? Into 12 equal halves. Okay, so having done that, we are told that crank AB is moving in the clockwise direction and crank CD is what? Rotating in the what? In the anti-clockwise direction. Okay, so I am going to, this is my point A right here, and this is my what? This is my point C right here. Okay, so with this area as my point B, here is my point B, okay? And we are told that the distance between point B and D is what? Is 120. With my compass and length 120, I strike an arc right here. So, and it actually sits right here. So I'm going to pick my ruler, join it from this area, okay, down to this point here like this. Okay, and this is my point what? This is my point D. And we're told that the distance between D and F, then B and E is what? Is 30. With my compass measuring radius 30, B to E. This is my E, all right? I'm going to asterisk it because we are plotting the locus of what? For point E and point F. Then D to F. Okay, I'm going to asterisk that position also as my what? As my point F. So what are we going to do now? This crank AB rotates what? Clockwisely. Therefore, this will be my next point. B1, B2, B3, B10, B11. And this is my crank CD rotates what? Anticlockwisely. So this will be my what? D1, D2, D9, D3, D10, and what? And D11. Okay, so as this one switches position, all right, to point B1, I pick my compass, I measure what? 120. B to D is what? 120. Then I pick my compass. So by the time I strike it, my D1 is somewhere here. All right, that's it. But I'm going to ensure my B1 passes through what? Passes through point D here. Okay. So it's going to pass through this area right here. Then D is the mark of D itself. So from that mark of point D itself, which is right here, this is my new D1 now, okay, which is right here. So from that point of my D1, I'm going to strike what? 30 to get my what? To get my F1. Then I'm going to what? Asterisk that point. Likewise, on my B1 here, I'm going to strike what? 30 on that line to get what? To get my what? What? Point E1, which is what? Which is right here, point E1. So we are replicating the same procedure on what? On B2. From B2, I pick my compass, you understand? I strike an arc down here this manner, then I'm going to what, draw a line from point B2 towards this. I will see now, it's just like an alternate line. Okay, I drag it across. So, and this is where the line arc of 120 touches line of what? B2D. So these are what? This is our new D2 as it is. So from this point with arc 30, with length 30, strike. This is my what? F2, and with mark 30, I strike on line BD. This is my what? My E2. All right, so I am replicating the same thing. I'm going to pick my, okay, first of all, let's draw the line. Let's do it this way. On this area to B3, okay, let's draw a line across in that manner. Then with our length of 120 from point B, we strike an arc. Okay, we strike an arc, and this is where the arc touches BD. So this point is our, is our new D3. So it's representing our D3. Okay. So then from this point of D3, we mark what? 30. We mark 30. So and this our new what? Our new F3. Then from B3, I strike what? 30, this is my what? My E3. Okay, so from B4, I pick my compass. Okay, I'm going to strike a big arc and this time around. Then with my ruler to D4, I'm going to what? Draw a line to what? B4. Okay, so this here, the arc I strike earlier on touches here. Okay, so from this point, I mark my what? My F4. I asterisk F4. F4 right there. Then from B4 with length 30, I strike what? To get my what? Point E4. So doing the same thing on B5. So let's do this way. B5 to this point of D5, let's draw a straight line all through like this. Okay. So then on that line, pick your 120 from B5, okay, and strike. So wherever it touches it, that's your what? That's your new D5. Then from that point, D5, with my mark 30, I strike and arc, and this is my what? This is my F5. Then from point B5, I strike and arc. This is my what? This is my E5. All right. So replicating the same thing on our point B6. B6 to its alternate here. Okay, so I draw a straight line all through. Then from B6, I measure what? 120. So wherever the 120, so this is my new point of what? Of D6. Then from point D6, I measure what? 30. Strike an arc of 30. So this my point what? F6. And from B6 here, mark 30. This is my point what? Point E6. All right, so from B7 towards B7 here, okay, I'm going to what, draw a straight line all through. Okay, on that straight line with my mark 120, okay, I strike an arc, which is what, which is it here. Okay, then I'm going to pick my compass from mark D7. I measure what, 30 to get what, F7. Then from B7 here, I measure 30 to get what, E7. All right, so with my ruler from B8 towards to D8, which is in this manner, I'm going to what, draw a straight line all through with my mark 120 from B8. Okay, I strike an arc on that line. So this is our new D8. From that new D8, pick your compass, place it there, and what, and strike an arc. These are what, these are our F8. Then from B8 here, I strike an arc. This is my what? E8. Okay, so from B9, pick your ruler, align it to what? To this area of D9 here. Okay, then what? Draw a line passing through it. Pick your compass of length 120. Strike an arc. So this is our D9. Then from point D9, pick your compass, strike to get what? Point F9. Then from B9. Strike to get what? Point E9. Okay, I'm doing the same thing on mark 10 from B10. Okay, B10 to D10 with my ruler, I draw. After drawing with my length 120 on that line, I strike. So this is my new point of what? Of B10. With my compass, measure 30. With 30, I strike and arc to get my what? My F10. Then on that line of B10, place my compass here, I strike an arc. This is my what? This is my E10. That's my E10. All right. So on mark B11 towards to D11, which is here. To D11, which is here. I draw it all through. Okay. So with my length 120 from, I strike. So this is my new what? This is my new D11. Then with my mark 30, I place it right on that mark of D11. I strike. This is my what? My F11. And from this area B11 here, I strike 30, and that's my what? That's my new what? New E11. So as it stands now, this is my E1, E2, E3, E4, E5, E6, E7, E8, E9, E10, E11, and this is my point F1, F2, F3, F4, F5, F6, F7, F8, F9, F10, and what? And F11. So picking my French curve, I'm going to join the points of E all together and the points of F all together. So that is the locus of what? Of point E. It remains for F now. and this is the locus for what, for point F. All right, kindly ensure you subscribe to this YouTube channel and also refer it to your friends who might be in need of it. Thank you.